I was arrested outside Whitehaven's Tarrawonga mine near Boggabri. The following day, my granddaughter Neve was born. I had decided to make a stand against Whitehaven because the previous week, on the 23rd of September 2014, the UN Secretary General then, Ban Ki-moon, had called for concerted global climate action to put our house in order to make it livable for future generations. Today, in Australia, that vision has gone out the window. The Albanese Labor government has given up on Neve's generation. In a moment, I will describe conditions in Australia in 75 years' time, at the end of this century, when Neve will be only a little older than I am now. Neve has just turned 10. She spends much of her time upside down doing cartwheels on the lawn or aerobatics on the trampoline. Her level of energy would be expected to set her up for a long and healthy life. She's also thoughtful about society. But will any sort of society that we would recognise even exist in 2099 at the end of this century when she's 85, which is not that much older than I am today, or some of the other nans here as well? The latest UN reports say that there are hard limits to what people can adapt to beyond 2 degrees. 3.5 is unthinkable, causing unsurvivable heat, ecosystem collapse, sea level rises inundating most of Australia's important infrastructure, and causing our beloved beaches to disappear. Shrinkage of arable land through drought, famine and wars over scarce resources. Disasters like fire, storms and floods will occur back to back, not allowing time for recovery in between. This is the world of 2099. I am enraged beyond measure that this government is willing to throw Neve's generation to the wolves for ephemeral political gain. Faced with such a grim reality, you would expect the government to do everything in its power to make greenhouse gas emissions fall. But Australia's greenhouse gas emissions are not falling, they're rising. There are currently plans for 100 new coal and gas projects in Australia. The government subsidises fossil fuels to the tune of $11.1 billion a year. They also subsidise gas infrastructure with about $2 billion. Ironically, if the government decided it didn't have to spend this money and had the courage to introduce a carbon tax, there would be plenty to accelerate the clean energy revolution and transform Australia into a clean energy superpower. Just after Neve's 10th birthday, despairing at the lack of action to protect our vital native forest from industrial logging, I locked myself onto a logging machine. Very anxiously awaiting trial for a newly created offence which may carry a jail term.